Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are discussing about programming in Java. What is this? We need to learn about Java evolution and Java features. So here we need to learn about first one is Java evolution, next Java features, and the Java features compiled and interpreted, platform independent and portable, object oriented, robust and secure, distributed, familiar, simple and small, multi-threaded and interactive, high performance, dynamic and extensible. And also we need to mention one of the Java weakness. So Java evolution. Java was developed by a team of computer professionals under the guidance of James Gosling at Sun Microsystems in 1991. Java was designed for the development of software for consumer electronics devices. Whatever the software developed in the year 1990, Sun Microsystems has released on the name of Oak, which is originally name of Java. The Oak has taken 18 months to develop. The Oak is unable to fulfill all requirements of the industry. So James Gosling again reviews this Oak and released with the name of Java in the year 1995. Scientifically, Java is one of the coffee seed name. Okay, now the entire Java is divided into three categories. One is J2SE Java Standard Edition, J2EE Java Enterprise Edition, J2ME Java Micro or Mobile Edition. Okay, so here J2SE we can develop client side applications, J2EE we develop server side applications, J2ME mobile or wireless applications by making it. Okay, so now Sun Microsystems is not available in the industry, so this company is merged with Oracle Sun. Now the latest releases are coming from Oracle Sun, and the latest version is Java 13. Okay. So the Java features are compiled and interpreted. Second one, platform independent and portable. Third one, object oriented. Next, robust and secure. Next, distributed. Next, familiar, simple and small. Multi-threaded and interactive. High performance and dynamic and extensible. So the first one is compiled and interpreted. Java combines both these approaches, thus making Java a two-stage system. First, Java compiler translates source code into what is known as bytecode instructions. Bytecode are not machine instructions, and therefore, in the second stage, Java interpreter generates machine code that can be directly executed by the machine that is running the Java program. So here, this is the source code. First.java is the source code. With the help of the compiler, we are converting this source code into what are known as bytecode. With the help of Java interpreter, it is nothing but JVM, we are converting this bytecode into machine instructions and run the program. Okay, that is what exactly explained. So Java has two stages of execution. One is compiler and second one is the interpreter. So next one is platform independent and portable. Java is compiled to an intermediate form called Java bytecode or simply bytecode. A Java program never really executes immediately after compilation on the host machine. Rather, this special program called the Java interpreter or Java virtual machine reads the bytecode, translates into corresponding host machine instructions, and then executes the machine instruction. A Java program can run on any computer system for which a JVM and some library routines are installed. Because of platform independence, Java programs can be portable from a mini computer up to a supercomputer irrespective of the hardware requirements and operating system base. So simple, I am developing with the help of the Windows, I am developing a Java program. After compilation, we will get bytecode. This bytecode is enough for running in either Windows or Mac or Linux or Unix. So portability is nothing but platform independent plus architecture utility. So the next one is object oriented. Java is one of the pure object oriented programming languages where every construction of the program should be written under the implementation of class, which is the basic part of object oriented programming. It means that it supports all the concepts of object oriented programming. Already in the first video we learned the concepts of object oriented programming. They are nothing but class, object, data encapsulation, data abstraction, inheritance, polymorphism, dynamic binding, and message passing. Now, robust and secure. Robustness is measured with the help of two concepts. One is memory management and second one is exception handling. Java completely managing the memory in dynamically. So the memory allocation is done in a very proper way. In traditional applications, the program is responsible for both allocations and deallocations of memory. In Java, memory allocation is controlled by Java Virtual Machine, where object creation is done by the user, deallocation is taken by garbage collector. In C or CPP, error handling is done manually even before running the program. If any runtime error comes, the program is in inconsistent state, which leads to memory leak. Java supports pure exception handling, which guards the program from abnormal situations. Java is intended to work in networked and distributed environments by providing security. Security becomes an important issue for a language that is used for programming on internet. Java systems not only verify all memory access but also ensures that no viruses are communicated with an applet. The absence of pointers in Java ensures that programs cannot gain access to memory locations without proper authorization. Distributed. Java is designed as a distributed language for creating applications on networks. It has the ability to share both data and programs. Java applications can open and access remote objects and internet as easy as they can do in a local system. This enables multiple programmers at multiple remote locations to collaborate and work together on a single project. This is an internet, this is one server, and the remote systems are there. This is the way the distributed communication system will be done. Now, familiar, simple, and small. By using Java, different range of applications can be developed by keeping the common structure, which is understood by JVM. Java uses many constructs of C and C++, and therefore Java code looks like C++ code. Multithreaded and interactive. Multithreaded means handling multiple tasks simultaneously. It is one of the important features of Java that provides multitasking, where two parts of a program can be runnable concurrently by sharing the common block of resources. This feature greatly improves the interactive performance of graphical applications. So before going to discuss about multithreading, I will also mention that what is process, what is multitasking, what is thread, and what is multithreading. Process is nothing but a program ready for execution. Thread is also similar to a process, but it is a lightweight component. Multitasking means more than one process run at the same time is called multitasking. Multithreading means more than one thread acquiring same resource at same time is called multithreading. Okay, so then you understand how important a thread is in Java program. So now, high performance. Java performance is impressive for an interrupted language, mainly due to the use of intermediate bytecode. Java architecture is also designed to reduce overheads during runtime. So dynamic and extensible. Java is capable of dynamically linking in new class libraries, methods, and objects. In Java classes that were unknown to a program when it was compiled can still be loaded into it at runtime. Java programs support functions written in other languages such as C and C++. So, apart from these features, Java has one disadvantage. Java is that it does not directly support true decimal value. Let us take double x is equal to 5.02 and double y is equal to 0.01. When we sum it, it prints 5.02399 and so on. So, but the result will be 5.03. Thank you.